Hello my dear students, this is your biology teacher Shivani Dikshit and we are going to discuss today the fifth point of the topic absorption by root, and the point number fifth is plasmolysis process. So we will discuss what is this plasmolysis and what is its significance in our daily life and what is its significance in plant's life. So let's understand. First of all, we will define the definition of plasmolysis. As we know that this plasmolysis phenomena occurs only in living cells, and its definition is shrinking of the protoplasm of a plant cell from its cell wall under the influence of hypertonic solution. Right, we can say that in a cell protoplasm is present, that is 90% of the water content, and this protoplasm will be shrinked because for example we have taken a living cell of plant and we have kept that living cell in the hypertonic solution. And due to the higher concentration of that solution, the cell itself releases its protoplasm outside the wall and the cell becomes shrink. So the process is called plasmolysis, right? Next we will move over the term, that is this process occurs due to the exosmosis. I have explained in my previous video what is exosmosis and what is endosmosis. When the cytoplasm releases from the cell outside, it is known as exosmosis. If it will come inside due to the tonicity of the solution, then it is known as endosmosis, right? So this plasmolysis is a vital process and it occurs only in living cells. We can understand the term plasmolyzed cell. When and how a cell becomes plasmolyzed? The question is that when and how the cell is called or cell is known as plasmolyzed cell. So we will understand when a plant cell kept in a hypertonic solution, means hypertonic means a solution its tonicity is very much high, concentration is high of that solution. So the protoplasm of the cell along with its cell wall will also be included along this solution or protoplasm. Membrane separates from cell wall, it get concentrated and vacuole become smaller. This is the phenomena after the plasmolysis process, the cell become plasmolyzed cell. And here is the example. I have taken here a cell, that is a plant cell, and in this plant cell, this condition is turgid condition. Turgid, I have explained you, fully distended or inflated in the shape, have a fixed, a flexible, rigid shape we can say. So this is the condition, turgid condition of the cell. But when we keep this cell into the hypertonic solution, then this cell content means this is the protoplasm of cell, protoplasm. And this protoplasm cell, due to the hyperconcentration of the solution, get shrink towards the inside or in between to the cell with its cell wall. This is cell wall. So this is shrinked cytoplasm with cell wall, and inside this the vacuole is present and this vacuole get smaller. So after becoming this vacuole smaller, the protoplasm inside the cell with its cell wall. The process is called plasmolysis process. Next, we will understand the daily life phenomena of the plasmolysis. What is the importance of plasmolysis in our life and in human life, in plant life also as well. Let's see it. So let's see the examples of the plasmolysis process in our daily life. We will understand how all foods are preserved. In our daily life, we have observed lots of preservative foods, canned fruits, canned vegetables, jam, jelly, packed pickles. How all these things are preserved? These are the preservative by the process called plasmolysis. Because we know that when the high concentration of the salt and sugar will be added in the any fruit or vegetable, then due to the process plasmolysis, the inner cells of these particular fruit or vegetable will be losses its protoplasm, so that the shrinkage of the protoplasm will take place inside the cell, and that process help out to prevent the particular food from the decay of the bacterial or fungal infection. So we can say that the plasmolysis process is very much important in our daily life to prevention of the food and various type of vegetables. Next thing we can say that prevention of the growth of the plant, as we almost see that where we don't want to see the plants, they will grow up. In between the crops, the unnecessary weeds will grow up. Then what happens? We will have to pour a hyper concentrated solution over the crop so that unwanted weeds and unwanted plants will be killed. Due to the process plasmolysis, because roots are very soft and they are having hypotonic solution at that time, and the entry of the hypertonic solution in the roots, the cell cytoplasm will be shrink, and then the process of the cell's roots will be stopped, so that the cell will be lost its doing function. We can say that we can also preserve jam, jelly and pickles from the process, that is plasmolysis. Now understand its significance in plants. Weeds can be killed in a drought by adding large quantities of salt in their root, as I have already told you. Plants growing in the walls, foundations of buildings are killed by adding salts. Root cell of such plants are killed due to the process, that is plasmolysis. So we will understand that sometimes we have observed that buildings are there, on the sides of the buildings, on the foundation of the buildings, unwanted plants will be grown up automatically. We don't want to grow up them. So what we have to put them, we have to pour a salt that is having the high concentration, so the root cells will be loses its protoplasm, and while they loses its protoplasm, the cell will be become shrink, and protoplasm will be shrink, and when the protoplasm will be shrink, then there will be no activities, no cyclosis process and no activity conducting in the plant cell, and automatically they will stop growth. So this is all for the term plasmolysis. Here we have all studied its definition, its significance in daily life and its significance in plants also. Right? That is all for the day. Have a nice day.